There's still a Toon's place here, and he's gonna show you now a detail from the reverse triangle. So you go from the back right and go there. Okay, so let's find it out.
So actually been discussing this with Wim yesterday or the day before yesterday, I don't even know. So when we're on back mount, I usually my techniques focus on leg locks, and we talk about that, but I also like to do jiu-jitsu from other places than leg locks. If we have back control, I have a few videos on a basic rear naked choke, but I was experimenting with some more stuff here. Actually in back control, it's a fair fight now between my two hands and Wim's two hands. And as Wim knows, I don't like to fight fair, so I want to take out the odds. I know Wim actually likes to get this arm underneath and control the foot, right?
Like this one.
This is what he likes. So we're going to work with that, and a famous guy once told me, give him what he wants until he doesn't want it anymore. So I'm going to give him what he wants. We're going to focus on a good control, getting my hip a bit out. And as he starts to grip right or not, I want to control this wrist. Yeah, I want to push it down and get my leg over and put it on his hip. With tension, yeah? Now I know Wim has some speciality in this, but most people, they just get their hand stuck and just want to pull it out. Mm-hmm. Now it's important that I keep this underhook. So I'm gonna use my choke hand to work this hand off, and I keep this underhook here. This hand becomes free, I'm gonna post on the mat, and I'm gonna shove back. Boom. I'm gonna catch my own shin under his neck, I'm gonna fall to the side and close my triangle here. Now, I'm gonna show you from a different angle, we need to get rid of the space between his carotid artery on this side and my knee. So if I'm too much laying behind him, then there's space here. Yeah, you can see that Wim can put his fingers inside. This is never going to be a choke. So what I like to do is pose and just AB. Yeah, just get this motion. Now my calf closes off. If he keeps his hands here or close or whatsoever, I can have a triangle by just squeezing here and I get a proper triangle. Now most people want to take their arm out because they know this is hard to get rid of. They know if they take space away from this carotid artery, there's no choke. So if he takes the arm out, it's hard for me to choke, right? In MMA, I especially love the position because I could just stomp his face. Now this arm is what I'm looking for if the triangle is not working. I'm going to swim underneath and I'm going to collect the elbow. Like I always imagine catching a heel hook because that's my, I don't know much else. I want to catch the elbow. I don't want to go for the wrist, because he can just bend his arm. There's not much of an armbar happening here. I'm just losing a lot of space and giving him slack. So I want to catch the elbow, like here, or like a heel hook, and fall to the side and overstretch his arm. If I still want to go for the triangle, which is very much possible, I'm going to give him a new shoulder, this one. I'm going to insert it on the side of his neck, and as I squeeze, usually the fist just makes it happen. I squeeze with my legs and just get the fist in to get a choke. I could use my secondary hand and catch his head or catch with my elbow, chin strap and push everything. But you see, I'm collapsing. And I like to stay on top here, especially in MMA. I don't want to fall down. So I stay on top. We have the armbar, we have the normal triangle, we have the fist in triangle. If he puts his head to the left side to prevent me from getting the fist in, I make like a cat paw, put it in, squeeze, and it's still squeezing. The final detail, I don't really like going for this one, but it's a nice detail. I catch like a heel hook, gable grip, I fall, and I make like a shoulder lock on his shoulder. So let's see it from a different angle. So I'm back. I usually suggest first just trying to get the choke and keep your control. Yeah? But he has both of his limbs using. Most people tend to have a big problem if you catch their arm. So we go here, we put it on. Make sure you get pressure here, so don't leave it slacking here, because this is the space where he's not gonna lift, he's just gonna weave it underneath. Boom, and he's back. Yeah? And usually escape. So get it close. I can also control this one, and now I can fight for the choke. Boom. Until I'm sure I have it. Catch the shoulder, 3-1, and then we rush to my arm. I'm usually first. But this case I want to go for the triangle. So I'm gonna pose, I'm gonna keep this hand here. This is gonna catch my shin. And I'm gonna hip escape behind. Catch my own shin, like this. This is the first control position. Now don't leave this leg dangling here too much or putting it on this side. I like to immediately get to the triangle. Now this is also a triangle, but look at my left foot. Wim can start working with the foot, peeling it off, catching and doing all kinds of stuff. So I like to close the triangle and hide it behind his butt, extending my leg. So he can feel the pressure between this one and this one. I'm not squeezing my triangle yet. This is just my outside leg, yeah? Control my own shin, AB, so this space, I have to get rid of this space. So AB like this. Now I can keep my hand here or let go and push this in and just squeeze for the normal triangle. Usually, especially when many people keep their hand here or they want to work it out, it gets space. So I can either catch the arm and then I can choose attacking the arm or attacking the triangle with my fist in his artery, pushing, pulling, pushing, extending, 1, 2, 3, yes. And choking. So that's the variation.
Really nice. This is my favorite position, actually, the reverse triangle, and at least 3-4 details that I didn't know yet. For example, that fist I never use. I always focus too much on the triangle.
Yeah, in training I don't really like to do it because it sets a tone to put your fist into someone's throat, but it's Jiu Jitsu, you know?
I do it with my worst enemies and my best friends.
Exactly. That's one.
Yeah. So Tumen's got his own channel as well on YouTube. I'll leave the link down below. And also check out his DVD on BJJ Fanatics. It's also the link down there for leg locks unlocked. So definitely check it out.
Thank you, Wim.